G'day, I'm Hans, and when I picture a security officer, I think of a bloke about the size of my car in a yellow vest making sure Justin Bieber's okay. But these days, security officers, they don't have yellow vests, and honestly, most of them don't even know Justin Bieber. They use things like this because they're IT security specialists, and they're the ones responsible for our security every time we go online. Today, we're at Bankwest headquarters, and if you're a bit of a computer pro, this could be the job for you.
We all use the internet and we all have private information that we want to keep private, whether we're a giant business or just someone sitting at home on Facebook. IT security specialists deal with everything from passwords to identity access management and keep our info safe.
Hi, I'm Jean.
Hi Jean, I'm Hans. Nice to meet you. I'm here from Student Edge and I want to find out all about your job. Can you help me?
Yeah, sure. Follow me this way.
Let's do it.
So Hans, what would you like to know?
Everything. Well, I think the first thing is, what is a security systems Batman saver of the world do? What do you do?
Okay, so I'm an identity access and security analyst at Bankwest.
So what does that mean? Like, you have to manage the level of access that people have in the online networks.
Yeah, so basically we have a vast majority of systems and we look after provisioning and deprovisioning access to all of those. And we also help to manage the fraud and prevent fraud.
Basically, you are like a technology security officer.
Yep.
Prevent fraud, prevent the wrong money going in the wrong areas, that sort of thing.
Yeah, and we're trying to just protect our staff. So if anything does happen, they're covered, we're covered, and everybody's aware of what went wrong, and then we can identify the risk within the system and prevent it in the future.
Does everybody love you for doing that? All right, it's that time. It's time for the edge. Can you give me the answers I'm looking for?
Yes, I can.
Cool. First question is, what's the process to get the job that you have?
So basically you have to start off as being a very self-motivated person and somebody who has a willingness to learn. I understand education's not easy, but if you stick at it, you're gonna get to where I am today. After high school, I went straight into Challenger Institute of Technology and did my Certificate 4 and Diploma of Information Technology Networking. From there, I did work experience and got an ACS scholarship. At the moment, I'm doing a double major of Internet Working, Security and Design and Cyber Forensics.
Cyber Forensics?
Yep.
Are you like addicted to CSI? Do you walk around the office with a taser?
No, not exactly.
There you go. Second question. What sort of person is best suited to working in your job?
I'd say it's somebody who has that willingness to learn, who isn't afraid to ask questions, and can quickly adapt to processes, and is always willing to learn new processes. It's never a dull moment in my job, and you just have to be that driven.
And someone who likes computers.
Yeah.
Definitely. And the final question, if you could have done one thing differently, still end up exactly where you are today, but done one thing differently, what would you have done better?
I would have taken some of my own advice and actually asked more questions, because at the start of my education, I didn't find my niche and I was kind of left in limbo for a bit, trying to find out what I wanted to do. But then once I asked the right questions to the right people and found out what I wanted to do, it was just a breeze from there.
Oh, magic. Yeah. Thank you so much for answering the questions.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Let's go solve some CSI crimes. Well, there you go. Never underestimate the amount of brains and work that goes into protecting this little bad boy. Now, if you want more information on the job or you just want to get involved,
get onto studentedge.com.au.